please be sure to greet our musicians afterward. Enjoy.
Hello, everyone. My name is Gail Fleming. I am a faculty member at the University of Missouri St. Louis. This is our Women's Chorale, and we're so thrilled to be here with you this afternoon on this beautiful day inside this lovely venue. And thank you, Barb. I just want to start off by saying thanks to Barb Clinsick at this church. She is the events coordinator. She's running sound. She helped us set up today, so we thank you very, very much. I'd also like to thank my colleague and good friend, Dr. Barbara Harbach, who is the music minister here, minister of music here, and we will be singing one of her selections later on in the program. Thank you all for coming today. We have a mixed bag, a lot of variety, and I usually don't start off with us singing. I usually start off with us singing. Okay, erase, reverse, let's go the other way. I usually start off with all of us singing. However, our first number, I feel like we transmit so much in it, I would like to tell you what's going on. The piece was composed, arranged by Rosephanye Powell, who is an African-American female composer, probably the most famous African-American female composer. And she wants to get transmitted the song through the instruments and through the singers and the words, what it was like to leave at night as slaves to train at the Underground Railway. So I'm just going to tell you a few things that are going on so you'll know to look for those or listen for those as we sing this song. She uses the percussion in the song. We are very percussive. The singers are more percussive than just legato. It's very percussive. She repeats the word come, come, so that you come with. She says through it sort of a wail of a no, don't get weary. Don't get weary because you've got to come right now at night. So as we sing this song, I would like for you to imagine, and I'm going to dedicate this to Harriet Tubman, one of the great, she was a slave herself. She escaped slavery and helped others to freedom. She was a spy for the Union. And so, Harriet Tubman at night, freeing slaves, dead of night, come, keep the old lamps burning. I would like to say before we start that we have a substitute percussionist today, and we're really happy to have him. That is Charlie Albers, our Gervais, Laura Vieron and Gervais, our own Jesse Flanagan. Thank you.
a song that I've conducted for many years, and you, many of you have heard for many years. It's entitled Scarborough Fair. This is also arranged by a female. I didn't do this intentionally. Those of you who are directors like me, or you have good music studios, sometimes as I look for a song, the song finds me. And I think the first two songs, they found me for this group. So, when Simon and Garfunkel were singing Scarborough Fair with the canticle, we thought of a female to a man going up to maybe war or something like that of Scarborough Fair. When I started researching this particular version of it, well, we know tunes go back thousands of years, and this started in the Middle Ages in England, and it was actually about a man asking a woman to do impossible tasks to show her love for him. One of those tasks was make a cambric shirt with no thread, no needle. Find an acre of land. So it has a whole different meaning. He then says, I know these are impossible tasks, but as long as you try, I know that you won't. So this is this version by Anne Marie Hildebrandt, who is an American female composer living in New York City, Scarborough, and it features Amy Simon.